Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay, thanks for tuning in to our conversation around the skin microbiome and skin health. I'm Irene Chong, the founder of CHNE Lang, and our guest today is Petronee Hordard. She's a French renowned pharmacist and the skincare director of Sequential Skin. It's the first science-backed skin health analysis of your genetics and skin microbiome. Welcome, Petronee. Thank you for joining us in the conversation about the skin microbiome and to talk about its link both to skin issues as well as skin health. Petronee, would you like to share a little bit of a background about yourself? I know that you were raised in Paris, but how did you end up in Singapore? So give us a little bit of background.
Yes. So thank you very much, Irene. And it's really a pleasure to be here with you today. So, yeah, I grew up in Paris and I'm a pharmacist. So in France, pharmacy study is a 6 years program where you learn a lot about chemistry, microbiology, biology, extra. And I was very interested in formulation and perfume chemistry. So I took a master of science in cosmetology. So everything around skincare, skincare formulation and skin physiology. And 12 years ago, I moved to Singapore. Actually, I moved to Singapore because I really wanted to come and live in Singapore. And I started my career so in Singapore with an OEM manufacturer. So we were working in a research and development laboratory. I was working mainly on very specific product for dermatologists and around Southeast Asia. And since then, I always hold different position in skincare industry, always related to innovation and R&D, so skincare formulation and all this. And I also own my own cosmetic line called Petronee Dermo Cosmetic a few years ago, and about 2 years ago I met so the two co-founder of Sequential Skin, Dr. Oliver Worsley and Dr. Albert Dashi. So they are both molecular biologists, and they were working on this fantastic project that to me will really revolutionize the cosmetic industry. And And so it was a perfect match between their knowledge in molecular biology and my understanding of skincare formulation that come together to create this this company called Sequential Skin.
Amazing. Yep, because we know Sequential Skin as well, but we'll talk about that later. So looks like skin microbiome is the focus today. And you mentioned about your interest in skin microbiome. And let's talk about what skin microbiome is, because I know a lot of our audience here might not have heard of it or have heard of it, but do not have a complete understand of what skin microbiome is. So maybe we can discuss that, yeah? So
yes, definitely. So the actually microbiome, it's the genetic material of all the microorganisms, so including bacteria, virus, and others that live in and on the human body, which are integral to who we are, and it varies for each individual. So, and if we focus on the skin microbiome, which is our interest today, so when you focus on the skin itself, so the uppermost skin layer is the most active site where the skin microbiome resides, and it's in constant contact with our environment and works to protect us against pathogens, to influence or alter our immune response, and to break down natural metabolites. So it's really, you know, we need to think as a carpet on top of our skin.
Exactly. I totally agree with you about our skin is formidable, like barrier. And on this barrier, like you mentioned, there are all these microbes that live on it. And together with the acid mantle, it forms the first line of defense, which is so important to protect against environmental factors as well as pathogens. So it is important. But yes, it's only in recent years that everybody became aware of this importance. But by then, the sensitive skin incidence has already increased. In the recent years, there's this increasing research done and showing the link between sensitive skin as well as skin microbiome diversity imbalance. So it looks like people are doing something to their skin that is causing this imbalance. Right, Petronique?
So yes.
What do you think? This modern way of living, the way we cleanse our skin, the kind of skincare we put on our skin, you know, what do you think? Do you think this has got impact on our first layer of defense?
Yeah, so definitely. So as you say, now it's a demonstrated fact that, you know, when there is imbalance of the skin microbiome, this has a major role in the development of certain skin conditions and even skin reactions, so such as redness, inflammation, sensitive skin, and also skin conditions such as atopic dermatitis, acne, and rosacea. And we can really see the increase of all these skin reaction and skin conditions. And so it's only in the recent years that we understand that maybe the microbiome can have a link with all this. And what is interesting is we start to have a lot of study on this and the link between the microbiome itself and the sensitive skin. And there is one recent study done by Shiseido Research and Development team. And this study reveals a comparison between skin microbiome diversity of subjects with sensitive skin to lactic acid and non-sensitive skin. And it shows that the sensitive skin was found to have significantly lower microbiome diversity compared to the non-sensitive skin, and a lower proportion of certain type of bacteria, such as S. epidermidis and Propionium bacterium acnes, which is more commonly detecting on skin-resident bacteria. So definitely there is a link. We still don't know exactly, you know, what is the link between the sensitive skin and the microbiota, and we need to investigate it a bit more. But what we understand is, as you said, all our behavior around, you know, like over cleans and using a lot of products, and definitely has a major impact on the skin microbiome, but as well the pollution, because it's all the external factors. So the UV light, the pollution, the product we are applying every day on our skin, the over cleansing, all this has an impact on the skin microbiome. And it showed that the microbiome diversity is lower, and that's also why, you know, we have more sensitive skin and more reaction skin.
That's amazing, because more than half of the world population suffers from sensitive skin, and God knows how many of these percentages actually link to habits that kind of remove or interrupt the skin microbiome diversity. And that is why it is important. It would be great if we can test out our skin and find out our skin microbiome diversity as it is. And that is where sequential skin comes in, right? You guys have developed the world's first test kit. Maybe you want to share a little bit more about sequential test kit, and why do you think it's important to get this test done for everyone?
Yeah, so we developed this kit. So it's a skin patch. So it's a very simple process, and it only takes 10 seconds. And this patch you place on your forehead, and we can collect from your forehead, so your skin genetics, so what you are born with, and your skin microbiome, so it's your environment. And from this analysis, we are able to map out your skin profile at a molecular level. And from that, we can guide you on the ingredients you should look for or you should avoid as well in your skincare routine, as well as, you know, product matching recommendation according to your very own needs. And it's only going through this molecular analysis and that we can really understand, you know, what is the state of your skin, what are your predisposition, but what is your current state of your skin, and really adapt, you know, the ingredients that you should have in your skincare routine.
Yeah, it is amazing because only 10 seconds, and if you get this test done, you basically can know your baseline, whether your skin microbiome is healthy or not, right? And this little test skin strip that you put on your forehead can even allow the lab to test your skin at the molecular level. So in fact, end of last year, Sage and Elang collaborated with Sequential Skin, and we started a few focus group for the purpose of running an in-house, just a small in-house clinical trial. And our participant actually used our certified microbiome series for 1 month. But before they started to use the product, we actually made each of them do a sequential skin testing before they start using and after 1 month of using. So the sequential skin testing analysis that our participant did was actually sent back to the lab at Sequential Skin. And we are so happy with the result, because after 1 month of use, the result came out to be positive, as in very good. The skin microbiome was, the diversity was healthy. So Petronil, you were on the other side receiving our sequential test kit back. So would you like to share what the result was like?
Yes. So as I mentioned before, the first thing to look at is the microbiome diversity, because it will indicate, you know, what is the state of your microbiome, and is it healthy or not healthy? Is it balanced or unbalanced? And this really give you an indication of how many bacteria you have on and their abundance on distribution. And overall, a higher diverse microbiome is linked to a more favorable health parameter and healthier skin. So when you have a good balance between the different bacteria, it's really essential to keep your skin healthy and beautiful. And so for this study, when you do a study like this, you always take a time zero and after application. So we did T0 and after 28 days of application, and we compare the results. And what was very interesting, it's in 100% of the person tested, we have the skin microbiome was maintained. So it means that the product doesn't affect the skin microbiome at all. And in 80% of the participants, the skin microbiome diversity was even improved. So it means that the product has a positive impact on the skin microbiome. So meaning that you have a more healthy skin after using the product, which is the most important. So this result shows clearly the positive impact of the product on the skin of all the participants.
Yeah, thank you, Petronil. We were excited because it was only a 1 month of use, and we already see that the skin microbiome diversity was kept balanced, and most 80% actually increased the skin microbiome diversity. And I just want to ask, many of our audience do hear of skin DNA test kit. And at this point, I just want to clarify, what's the difference between the sequential test kit and the DNA test kit that they can get elsewhere?
Yeah, so looking at, with a DNA test kit, you only look at the genetic, so your genetic, what you are born with. So looking at your genetics, is really one part of the story, right? So similar to our DNA, the microbiome is unique to each individual, and it will change and evolve, you know, with the environment, the pollution, the stress, your heating habits, etc. And we believe at Sequential that it's really your nature, so what you are born with, the DNA, plus your nurture, so your environment, all the pieces together that give you this comprehensive skin report. So DNA and microbiome should not be isolated, but it should be combined in order to get a holistic view of the skin condition. And we can see clearly, you know, in the past few years that the impact of the microbiome diversity on the healthy skin. And having these two components is really crucial to really understand, you know, the state of your skin. And of course, with this skin patch, we didn't just want to tell about your skin profile, but our mission at Sequential Skin is really to go beyond and empower individuals to make better informed decision about their skincare and by giving consumer recommendation on how to improve their skin overall health, as well as guiding them on what work best for their unique profile.
Absolutely. In fact, our goal in Sage and Elan is really to define beauty, because beauty is not about fighting aging, but beauty to us is also restoring skin health, which is the same as Sequential Skin. So that's fantastic. And I just want to just bring back again what Petronie was mentioning about DNA tests. It shouldn't be just DNA test kit. You should know your DNA, your genetics, as well as your skin microbiome diversity, because these two will determine what your skin health is like. That's the reason why we collaborated with Sequential Skin, because we wanted our participants to know what their skin were like before they started using our product and at the end of it. And we were very, some of our participants was pleasantly surprised that their skin age, the genetics of the skin age actually improved after a month of usage. So definitely, if you should really consider getting your skin microbiome tested using the Sequential Test Kit. Yeah. So I think we are almost to the end of our conversation. And just one final thought on the importance of choosing your skincare products before we end this conversation.
Yes, so it's a broad question. So, yeah. But if I would like to share one or two tips, you know, and it's something that I'm applying also for myself. So first, when you cleanse your face, you need to cleanse your face every day, because, you know, especially women, when we're wearing makeup, you want to remove the makeup. But one important aspect, and especially for the, you know, to have a healthy microbiome, is not to over cleanse. Yes. So I will say, you know, if I can give an advice, is to clean, you know, remove your makeup, clean your face at night, but maybe in the morning you don't need to clean it again, but just rinse it with water, with cold water, not hot water, and don't over cleanse. And if you to look for products, don't look only on the claim, marketing claim that, you know, you have on the product, and if it's written sensitive, it's mean for sensitive skin. It doesn't mean that it's really mean for sensitive skin. And what is good to do is really to return the product and look at the back, where you have all the ingredient list. And if you compare two products, some they have a lot of ingredients inside, it's always good to go for a shorter inky list, ingredient list. So if you are hesitating between two products, take the one with less ingredients. So at least, you know, you don't apply too many chemicals on your skin every day.
Excellent tip. Yeah, do not over cleanse. That is what I constantly tell my audience. Don't over cleanse. And I totally agree that you don't have to cleanse your face with too much of soap in the morning, because your skin is not dirty overnight. So yes, I completely agree with that practice of just washing with water in the morning. And also reading labels is what I advocate as well. So I totally agree with you. Two simple tips on how do you choose your skincare product. So that is all for today. I think we covered most important thing about skin microbiome, about why you should test your skin to find out the genetics as well as your microbiome diversity, and how to choose a skincare. So I think this has been a very good conversation. So thank you so much, Petronille. It was great chatting with you. And thank you all for tuning in. Perhaps next time we can have a chat again.
Yes, yeah. Definitely. Thank you very much, Irene. It's always a pleasure.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.